वेलकम बैक टू द बिजनेस स्टडी क्लास एंड टुडे वी कंटिन्यू विद अवर चैप्टर 8 दैट इज सोर्सेस ऑफ बिजनेस फाइनेंस एंड इन द प्रीवियस क्लास आई टॉक यू अबाउट द फैक्टरिंग एंड लीज फाइनेंसिंग बोथ आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एस्पेक्ट ऑफ द सोर्सेस ऑफ बिजनेस फाइनेंस इफ यू आर हैविंग एनी डाउट रिगार्डिंग टू दैट काइंडली लेट मी नो थ्रू व्हाट्सएप सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी वन मोर सोर्सेस ऑफ बिजनेस फाइनेंस दैट इज कॉल्ड पब्लिक डिपॉजिट्स ठीक है सो
Public
by the organization is called public deposit. Rates of interest offered on public deposit are relatively higher than that offered in the bank deposit. Any person who is interested in depositing money in the organization can do so by if you want to deposit beyond bank, if you want to deposit in any other organization, you can do so by filling up the prescribed form. The organization in return issue a deposit receipt as an acknowledgement of the debt. Public deposit can take care of both medium and short term financial requirement of a business. The deposit are beneficial both to the depositor as well as to the organization. While the depositor gets higher interest than that offered by the bank, the cost of deposit to the company less than the cost of borrowing from the bank. Okay. So it's a very simple way of accepting deposit from the public by prior permission from the required authorities. Now merits. It's a simple process. It's a very simple process of accepting money from public. Really simple process. Cost is lower than banks. Cost is comparatively lower than the banks and financial institution. Clear? At the same time, public deposit do not create any charge on the assets. Clear of the company. The asset can be used as security for raising loan from other sources. As assets are free, they can be used. As security for other purposes. As security for other purposes. As the depositor do not have voting right, the control of the company is not diluted. The customer depositor will just get the receipt of the amount deposited and does not avail of voting rights. Okay? So the ownership of the person is not diluted by issuing public deposits. So they are beneficial in the ways. Now limitation. Okay? What are the limitations that we see? Okay. Now it's a problem for new company. How does it create a problem for the new company? Because new company find it difficult to raise the money through public deposit because they don't have public image. New company has to show his or her work. So it would be very difficult for a new company to ask from the public to give a public deposit. Okay? Sometimes it is an unreliable source. Source of finance. Why? Because there are so many new companies are being formed and the public do not have faith on those companies. So sometimes it will be very difficult. So public deposit will turn out to be an unreliable source of finance when the company needs money. Okay? And at the same time, collection of the huge amount is very difficult. Collection of huge amount is sometimes very difficult. Petty amounts you can collect, but to collect the huge amount, it will be very difficult because some companies do not possess the public image. Clear? So in this way, public deposit works. Now we will study the second, that is for commercial paper. Second is commercial paper. So commercial paper emerged as a source of short term finance in our country in the early 90s. Commercial paper is an unsecured promissory note issued by a firm to raise the fund for a shorter period, varied from 90 days to 364 days. It is issued by the one business firm to another, insurance company, pension funds and bank. The amount raised by commercial paper is generally very large and the debt is totally unsecured. The firms having good credit rating can issue the commercial paper and its regulation come under the purview of RBI. Commercial paper again is a way of raising funds by some reputed companies from some other company, generally from 90 days to 365 days. So it generally it is issued by one firm to the another, and that the amount is totally unsecured, means you have to just rely on the performance of another company and you have to give the money. So that is totally unsecured. So firms having good credit rating can issue the commercial paper, and its regulation come under the RBI. The merits and limitation of commercial paper are as follows. The merits of commercial paper. First, as they are totally unsecured. As the commercial paper are totally unsecured and does not contain any restrictive condition, but it does not contain any restrictive condition as to the use of the amount. Secondly, it is a freely transferable instrument. Freely transferable instrument. Now, what does it mean, freely transferable instrument? Means you have bought the commercial paper of some company, now you are in need of funds. So the same commercial paper you can sell it to somebody else if anybody is ready to buy those commercial paper. So in this way you can raise fund for yourself also. As it is unsecured, so it can raise more money because good amount of return is involved in it. It can raise good amount of money. And it's a continuous process. It's a continuous process of raising the fund, because the moment you have bought the paper of some other company and you are in need of funds, you can immediately transfer the same instrument to some other company. And when you possess some extra funds, extra or idle funds, you can use your fund in this way by issuing commercial paper or by buying the commercial paper. In both ways you can do. Now see the limitations of commercial paper. Every company comes with the both aspect, benefit, merits and demerit, advantages and disadvantages. So definitely commercial paper also has some kind of limitation. So what are the limitations? Only reputed companies can deal in it. As the loan is totally unsecured, so only the companies of the high repute can deal in the commercial papers. New and moderately rated firms are not in a position to raise fund by this method. normal and newly established company or the companies with a lower track record, it is not possible for them to issue or raise commercial paper. Similarly, the size of the money, size of the money that can be raised to do the commercial paper will not be very huge amount. Clear? Because excess and liquidity available with the supplier of the funds at a particular time. Clear? Now, sometimes what happens, further maturity of the commercial paper is not possible. Further maturity of commercial paper is not possible. Clear? So, due to the financial difficulties, clear? So, because of the some financial difficulties, country's political situation or some like that, if a firm is not positioned to redeem its paper due to financial difficulties, extending the further maturity of the commercial paper is not possible. Clear? So, definitely there are some merits and limitations of this aspect. Now, we are going to study the issue of shares. Next method of raising the fund. Next is issue of shares. What does issue of shares mean? The capital obtained by issue of share is known as share capital. The capital of a company is divided into the small amount called share. Okay. Now, what it has been done, a very big amount of capital is broken into small parts. For example, clear? You are having a capital of 1 crore of rupees. Clear? 1 crore of rupees you are having capital. Now, what you can do? Clear? By this 1 crore, you can break them into small capital. Now, 10 lakh equity shares of rupees, 10 each. Now, what you have done? You have broken the very big capital into the smaller unit called A share. And these shares are issued to the public at large. Clear? So, 10,000 or 10 lakh equity share of 10 rupees each, 10 each will be issued to the company. The person holding the share is known as the shareholder. There are two types of the share normally issued by the company. Clear? Now, shares are of two types. First is equity and second is preference. First is equity and another is preference. So, money issued by raised by issue of equity share is called equity share capital, while the money raised by issue of preference share is called preference share capital. Clear? Now, equity shares, they are the most important source of raising the fund and they possess the voting rights. Clear? They possess the voting rights of the company. They are actually the real owner of the company. Everything is decided with their consent. Clear? While the preference share will get a fixed amount of dividend. Preference shareholder will get a fixed amount of the dividend whether there is a profit or not, and they do not possess the voting right. Clear? So, in this way, equity shareholder are the real owner of the company in comparison to the preference share. And if there is no profit, equity shareholder will not get any amount as dividend. But for the preference share, you must provide them. So, they act like as a loan. Clear? So, equity shareholder do not get any fixed dividend, but they do not get any fixed amount of dividend, but they are paid on the basis of earning by the company. So, they are also referred to as residual owners, while the preference shareholder will get preference in terms of dividend. Clear? So, they will get what is left after making all the claims of the company income and assets have been settled. They enjoy the reward as bear the risk of ownership. Their liability, however, is limited to the extent of capital contributed by them in the company. Further, through their right to vote, these shareholders have a right to participate in the management of company. So they are called the real owner of the company in comparison to the preference shareholder. Okay. So now, merits of equity shares. Equity and preference. Clear? So, merits of issuing equity shares. So, these type of shares are useful when you are having a higher return. When you are having a greater risk and higher return, in that situation, you can issue equity share when you are expecting or willing to assume risk for higher return. Payment of dividend is not compulsory. Dividend means amount payable as an investment. Dividend, payment of the dividend is not compulsory because they are called the residual owner or actual real owner of the company. So whatever is paid to them, whatever is left after making all the or settling all the claims. Clear? So at the same time, we are also called the permanent capital. We are also called the permanent capital of the company and are not going to be repaid during the entire lifetime of the business. But if you have invested any amount in the form of equity share and you are in need of money, you can sell your share through stock exchange. You can sell through the stock exchange. Clear? Stock exchange are called secondary market. Equity capital provide credit worthiness to the company and confidence to the prospective loan provider. Funds can be raised through equity share without creating any charge on the assets of the company. The assets of the company are therefore to be mortgaged for some other borrowing. Democratic control over the management of the company is assured due to the voting rights of the equity shareholder. So the equity shareholder are able to maintain the democracy in the business enterprises. Clear? Now definitely we will study some limitations also. So what are those limitations? Clear? Now as I told you that this is the permanent capital, so person who is willing to get regular income, a person who wants regular income, so the investment in equity share is not for them because there is no guarantee because profit is fluctuating. Okay, so it's not guarantee that you will get regular income in investment by making investment in equity shareholder. The cost of equity shareholder is generally more as compared to the cost of raising funds through other sources. Okay, so issue of equity share is costly because lots of formalities of issuing of the share is required to be completed. Clear? And if you issue, are going to issue more equity shareholder, it is going to dilute your control over the management of the company. Clear? And lots of formalities are required. Nowadays, the process of issuing the share is very complex. Lots of formalities are required. Clear? To issue equity shares. So these are called, there are some limitations. Clear? Now we are going to study the preference shares. Oh, I thought this is sufficient for today. Rest we will study in the next class. Thank you.